So now, when we have written all this code, let's look at how to scale your application using modules. Modules are a serious heavy-duty function within App Engine, and they allow you to partition your code, have better control over scalability, and do version control and online upgrades. For simplicity, we did not use modules when building Conference Central, but it is something we strongly suggest you start exploring on your own by looking at the online documentation. All right, let's get started. When you create an App Engine application using modules, it will conceptually be structured like a tree. At the very top, we have the root, which is your application. And your application is made up of a number of modules, in this example, two. A module groups three concepts: code, related to the module; the instance class that should be used to execute the code — this is the speed of the CPU and the amount of memory that should be used — the scalability parameters, including the number of instances to start and their lifecycle. So a module groups code to be executed, the performance resources, and the scalability and instance lifecycle you want to have. Each module can then have a number of different versions associated with it. A version is essentially a version of your code being maintained in the module. So after you have deployed your application into production, you can deploy new versions of your code, and you can have multiple versions running in parallel and gradually migrate traffic from the old version to the new. This capability allows you to do version upgrades without having to bring down your application, something that is extremely difficult to do without App Engine. And finally, there are instances. An instance is what actually executes the application code. And if you want to scale your application, App Engine can fire up more instances to manage the additional load. And since the instance class and the number of instances define the performance and scalability of a module, the capacity of your application depends on the instance class and the number of instances you run. This is configured on the module level, and that is exactly what we will look at now: how to configure a module. So let's start by looking at two scaling options for modules: manual scaling and automatic scaling. These specify the different scale-up, scale-down characteristics of instances. Manual scaling allows you to create instances that are always up and running and that never terminates. Because of this, they don't have the 10-minute execution limit when they process tasks or cron jobs. Since they are always up and running, they can work for any amount of time. And that means that they are great to use if you have long-running background tasks or cron jobs. The only thing you need to configure for manual scaling is the number of instances you want the module to start. That's manual scaling. Let's now talk about automatic scaling. Automatic scaling is the option that allows App Engine to automatically scale your application up and down depending on the load. The first two options you can specify for automatic scaling is the minimum and maximum number of idle instances you want. What does this mean? Why would you want to have idle instances? Well, instances have a startup time. And if you don't want your users to wait for the response while your application needs to scale up by starting new instances, and it could be good to have idle instances available if your application needs to scale up so your users don't have to wait for more instances to start. Let's now look at latency, where you can specify the minimum and maximum pending latency allowed for requests. These parameters work as follows. So let's say a request comes into your application right here and there is no instance available to process it. Then it is put in a wait queue. App Engine now has a decision to make when to scale up your application using more instances. Well, to begin with, it will wait for some time to see if any of the existing instances become available to process the request. This is called the minimum pending latency. If this time passes, App Engine is considering starting a new instance to manage the request. And if the max pending latency time expires, then a new instance will be started for sure to manage the load. This is how App Engine performs a scale-up of your application. Rather than specifying a number for these four parameters, you can all set them to automatic. In such case, App Engine will set them according to a dynamic analysis it performs. Finally, both manual and automatic scaling have a common configuration element, which is the instance class. The instance class specifies the speed of the CPU and the amount of memory to use for each of the instances started. Check out the developer documentation for more details on the options available. As you probably see by now, modules is heavy-duty stuff. And in addition to the scaling options we looked at, it also has versions that we briefly touched on. Versions allow you to perform online upgrades on part of your system without any service disruption. Without App Engine, doing automatic scaling and dynamic upgrades are extremely difficult problems to solve. So make sure that you use this great functionality.